My name is Harry Shroff, and I work in the Intramural program at the NIH in the National Institute for Biomedical Imaging and Bioengineering. And what my lab tries to do is to develop new forms of microscopy that let biologists and medical researchers at the NIH and around the world look at things that were too small or too fast or too delicate to be seen with normal kinds of microscopes. There are a couple of things that are really spectacular about working at the NIH. One of them is that my background is sort of in biophysics, and I would say, you know, equally at home discussing biology and doing physics and engineering. But really the kind of bread and butter tools that we use are physical tools and engineering tools. And for somebody like me that tries to make better tools for biologists, the NIH is a great place because we're surrounded by biologists that are investigating all sorts of different systems, everything from molecules to cells to whole animals. And so this is a great environment for trying to find problems and for trying to really get at, you know, what are the technology issues that have to be addressed so we can explore that next frontier in biological imaging.
Want that click in to start up again?
You see all this stuff over here? This is that thing with that weird, remember this?
Oh yeah. Biologists want to look at a wide range of samples. Sometimes you want to look at single cells, but sometimes you want to look at tissues or even whole organisms. The type of microscope we were trying to improve upon is up until now has only been suitable for single cells. So what we've done here is we've extended, we preserved all the good qualities of that microscope, we hope. It's about as fast, it's has about the same resolution, you see just about as well, but you can look much deeper. So instead of looking at a single human cancer cell line that's been preserved, we're looking at a worm embryo developing, you know, from a single cell up to a hatched adult or a hatched adolescent. Or we're looking at a zebrafish embryo and an animal with organs and blood cells and an eye and a brain.
The other sort of more practical aspect that is really great about being part of the Intramural program is the sort of freedom to actually devote, you know, 90% of my time to actually doing research. One of the reasons that I came here, instead of going to like a more traditional university and becoming an assistant professor, is that here I'm in a way spoiled. I really don't have to write grants or teach, and I can devote sort of almost all my time to building these instruments, to participating, doing experiments myself, and then training, you know, the next generation of researchers, my postdocs and my postbacs.